Complement system is a system which consists of more than 30 proteins. Among these 30 proteins, the most important for us are 11 proteins, in which we have a C1 to C9 proteins and factor B and factor D. So this is a system in which these proteins exist as inactive enzymes. They are like enzyme precursors and they need to be activated by some stimulus. So here, this scheme represents the sequence of activation of the complement proteins, where we have the C1 protein getting activated, C1A, and this bar on the top of one indicates the activated component. Then C1, once formed, activates other proteins to C4-2, you see, activated, and there is a smaller product also formed because it is cleaving C4 into two products, C4B and C4A. So C4A is formed, which is a smaller product, and C4B component combines with C2 also. So this activated component is formed. Then this C4-2 activates C3 to C3B plus C3A. Then C5 gets activated to C5B and C5A. And then subsequently C6, C7, C8, C9 are also activated. And finally, a product is formed, which is important for the lysis of the cells. So this is the order of activation of the complement system. You see, mostly it is in the order of the numbers. However, this C4, C2 is coming here. So that we cannot do much because it is basically in the order of the discovery they were named. But still, very simple to remember that how this is getting activated. But there are certain characteristics of this complement activation. One, that it exists in the form of inactive precursors and needs to be activated. But once one protein is activated, here you see this one is activated, it is a cascade reaction. So series of reactions are taking place. So that is known as cascade reactions. And with the cascade reaction, there are certain advantages. That first of all, it is a rapid response, okay? And second, that it causes the amplification. Amplification means that the end product of one reaction subsequently activates larger quantities of the other products. So C1 will activate little more of C4 and C2, and C4-2 will activate little more of C3. So the end product which is formed is much, much more. So that is known as amplification. So how all this activation is taking place? Well, there are three pathways. Here two are shown. One you see here, antigen-antibody complex is shown, and the other microorganism plus B and D are shown. There is another pathway which acts at this level, direct activation of C4 and C2 occurs. So what are these pathways? See, these pathways ensure that ultimately the end product is formed on the surface of the microorganism. So in antigen-antibody complex, say suppose this is the antigen and here this is the antibody which is attached to the antigen. So this forms the antigen binding site of the antibody. Antibody has two sites, antigen binding site and the constant portion. And this forms the constant portion. Now this constant portion has a binding site for C1 complement protein. So once bound to microorganism, this binding site for complement protein opens up. Initially, it is like it can't bind, right? But once bound to microorganism, there is conformational change in this antibody structure such that that binding site for the complement protein opens up and it can bind to it and activate the complement system. So that is one method. And this method of activation is known as classical pathway for complement activation. Classical pathway. Fine. Then we have the alternate pathway for complement activation. And what is this alternate pathway? Let us see a little bit in detail. So in this alternate pathway, what we have is the protein C3. This protein C3 spontaneously gets converted into C3B and C3A. So you see here that we don't need any other stimulus for its activation. It is spontaneous, very slow activation into C3B and C3A. However, this C3B needs to bind to microbial surface for further activation. So suppose the microbe is present in the vicinity and this bounds to the microbe surface. Okay, so once it binds to the microbe surface, in the presence of another factor, that is factor B, what it forms is C3B, capital B. And then in the presence of factor D plus factor D, this C3B gets activated into C3BBB. So this component is formed, which is basically the C3 converting enzyme. So what it will do is that it will further act here and activate more and more C3 to its components. It will split C3 into its components. So you see what is happening here, a positive feedback loop is operating. So once it binds to the microbial surface, huge amount of C3B keeps on binding to it and more C3 converting enzyme is formed. And we have seen that what happens in the complement system, once it C3B forms, it activates C5 into C5B and C5A as well. So this is the alternate pathway of activation. But suppose I told you that this is spontaneous here, the conversion of C3 is happening to C3B spontaneously. So if the microbe is not available, what happens that this actually is inactivated. So if it is freely floating or it is bound to suppose host cell, then in the presence of some other factors, actually factor H and I, it gets inactivated. So it forms inactivated C3B. Okay, and further it is digested by other proteases. So this is kind of a control which is happening. Otherwise, you see a spontaneous activation, it will just go into a positive feedback loop. So that is the second pathway of activation. And third pathway of activation is mannose binding lectin pathway. What is this pathway? In mannose binding lectin pathway, it acts here where this is a protein, mannose binding lectin, which can directly activate C4, C2 to C42. So you see, these three steps, three pathways are there. Classical pathway, alternate pathway and mannose binding lectin pathway, and all are impinging in the formation of C3B. Why? Because this is important. This is the central point, as we have seen that C3B basically only when it is attached to the surface of the microorganism, then only this component will be remaining. Otherwise, it will be destroyed by factor H and factor I. So when C3B is attached on the surface and further reactions take place, what happens that this component that also forms on the surface of the microorganisms. Let us visualize it a little bit. So here you see a complicated diagram, but let me focus what we are talking here. So you see, this is the cell surface, that is the microbial surface, and the C3B is attached here. And what it is doing, that it is activating C5, which comes and binds to the microbial surface only. So all this should take place near the microbial surface, and all other factors C6, C7, C8, they come here and join this C5 such that they create a structure on the microbial surface, and this C9, that's why, is able to create a pore on the microbial surface. So these are not free floating components, they form on the microbial surface, and this is whole component, the complex is known as membrane attack complex, which is forming a pore on the surface of the microorganism. We will see in detail in the functions. So that was about the complement proteins and how they are activated. Basically, if you see that there is acquired immunity component, that is antigen antibody complex, which is activating the complement proteins. And there is innate immunity component also, where it is just the binding with the microorganism, it is activating the complement proteins. Fine. Now, what are the functions of these complement proteins? Now, if you see these cascade reactions, there are various end products being formed. There is C4A, there is C3A, C5A, and finally, this is the end product. That is a membrane attack complex. And these end products are very important for the functions of these complement proteins. And what are these functions? So first of all, this C3A, C4A and C5A, they cause activation of the mast cells and activation of the basophils. Okay, so when these cells are activated, what happens? They release two very important components, that is histamine. These chemicals are released, and heparin. These histamine and heparin, they increase the blood flow and they also increase the capillary permeability. Okay, so remember that all these components are forming where our microbe is there. Okay, then only this antigen-antibody complex is there, that is forming there itself where the microbe is there, right? And then C3b also, it is present on the surface of the microbe. So all these components are forming where the microbe is present. So this increase in blood flow, increase in capillary permeability is happening at the location of the infection. So once this happens, this is going to cause the edema, leakage of the fluid at the site of the infection, and there will be coagulation of proteins also near the site of the infection. So what happens? That antigen gets trapped there at the site of the infection. Okay, that is one thing. Second, because of increased capillary permeability, the WBCs which are moving from the blood, they can come out of the blood and stay here, right? So it facilitates the diabetes of the WBCs. So you see how this C3a, C4a, C5a are helping in inflammation. And by the way, because they activate mast cells and basophils, they are also known as anaphylotoxins. That is the term, anaphylaxis, right? Anaphylotoxins, okay? That is first function of complement proteins. Second function is chemotaxis. The C3a is responsible for the chemotaxis of eosinophils, okay? And C5a is responsible for the chemotaxis of neutrophils, right? So mast cell and basophil activation, second function being chemotaxis, right? So you see they were going in blood flow, plus they are getting attracted also to the site of infection, and by increasing capillary permeability, they are able to move out also, okay? Third, they also increase the killing mechanism of the neutrophil. They basically stimulate the respiratory burst of the neutrophils. Okay, stimulate the respiratory burst. So that is third thing. So you see how in each step they are helping the WBCs for killing the microorganism. Fourth, they are responsible for opsonization. And opsonization is the mechanism by which phagocytosis is enhanced. So this is the microorganism and this is the complement protein C3b, as I told you that it is bound on the surface. Now the WBC which comes, it has a complement binding site. So this C3b can bind to this site also. So neutrophils and microorganisms are coming closer to each other. So that is opsonization, again helping the WBCs kill the microorganism. Then finally, complement proteins also cause the lysis of the microorganisms, the end product, the membrane attack complex which is formed. That forms a pore on the surface. We have seen that diagram where all the complement proteins are formed on the surface and help in forming the pore. Because of this pore, now the ions and other solutes can enter the cell. The osmolarity of the cell is not maintained. Now water can also enter and ultimately the cell is going to burst. That is the membrane attack complex. Now apart from this lysis mechanism, there are other mechanisms also by which the microorganisms are controlled. One is agglutination, where basically the microorganisms, the bacteria adhere to each other. So if this is the bacteria, because of the attachment of the complement proteins, other bacteria also with the complement proteins get attached to each other like this. Okay, so this is known as agglutination. And other one is neutralization, where because of the binding of the complement protein on the membrane, the structure of the viruses, that is changed. And once that is changed, they are neutralized or become non-virulent. So these are the various functions of the complement proteins. In simple thing, you see that basically it is helping in each step. Let it be inflammation, increase in capillary permeability, more diabetes of the neutrophils, chemotaxis of the neutrophils, also of eosinophils, then increasing the killing mechanism, that is increased respiratory burst of neutrophils, opsonization and lysis. And all this is localized to the site of the infection because of the property of the C3b being attached to the microbial surface and rest of the activation of the complement proteins happening nearby only. So that was all about the complement system. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, do press the like button, share the video with others, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel Physiology Open. Thank you.